Okay, so for chapter 2, you need to go down. You need to go down here, looking for chapter 2. Okay. Yeah, I already changed the setting. Okay, I changed the setting to so you can do many times, not only just one time. Okay. Okay, how many numbers of tries? So maybe I can put like 100 times. Okay. So you can make it correct answer until 100 times. Okay, I think within 2 or 3 try as you can get the answer, right? Okay. Okay. Go to the homework again. Yeah, since so far you don't need to use the calculator or Excel. Okay. Let me go to the chapter 2. Okay. Okay, so it start with chapter, start with this one, okay? We call it the pie chart, right? Not the pizza chart, okay? Pie chart, okay? Okay, Kara categorized her spending for this month into 4 categories, okay? Rent, food, fun, and other. The amount she spent in each category are pictured here, okay? And the question is, how much total money did Kara spend this month? So that means you need to add all the money that she spent for food, rent, fun, and other. Okay. So you can calculate in your head, yeah. So if you add this one with this one, you 2 + 8 = 10, right? So you got 0 and then 1 + 2 = 3, 3 + 2 = 5, and then 4 + 5 = 9, right? So you've got 590, okay? And I think for this one is 590 also. So the total will be, how much is it? 950 plus 950, so you got 1900, right? Okay. And the next one. But the next one is a little bit different. In this case, you need to find what is the percentage. Okay. Yeah, you can watch the video. Or you could, there's a video is you can watch it, okay? So to find the percent her total spending that she spent on the rent is you need to find what is the total. The total will be, this is 900, right? So 900 plus 900 is 1800, right? So you need to divide 300 with 1800 and then multiply by 10%. Okay, let me use the calculator here. So, okay, go back here. So 300 divided by 1800. So 300 divided by 1800. 300 divided by 1800 time. Oops, sorry. Too many zero. Okay. And then time 100%, right? So the answer is 16.66666. Okay. And let's see. Answer to the nearest whole percent. So you need to round up to. Oops, sorry. I did this another time. Yeah, so if you want to write in whole percent, so you need to round up to 17%, right? So the answer here is 17%. Oops. What happened here? 900 plus 900, right? 1800, right? Let me see, I might make a mistake here. Oh, sorry. I see the wrong problem here. So it's looking for the percent of the total spending that she spent on rent. Okay, so sorry. It seems to be divided by, this one divided by, I mean, the money that is for the rent, which is 100 divided by 1800, right? So this one should be 500 divided by 1800 time 100%. Okay. So you need to round up to whole percent. So the answer is 28%. Okay. So I'll let you do many times, like 100 times. So you can fix it if you have any problem, if you got a wrong answer, something like that, okay? Okay, for this one is, based on the frequency distribution above, is 4. What is 4 here? Lower class limit, class boundary, upper class limit, class midpoint, or class weight, okay? So you can see 4 is here, right? None of them here, okay. But you see the difference between this and this, the difference will be 4, right? From here to here, difference will be 4. From here to here, difference will be 4. So 4 will be the class weight, okay? Because class weight is like different between two consecutive lower limit or upper limit, okay. So do you have any other problem other than this one? So the answer can be class midpoint. If this number is like the number between one of this class, okay. And the number is will be upper class limit if the number one of this number here, okay. And the number is class boundary if the number is like point five something like that, okay. And lower class limit if the number is one of this number here. Okay, so let's go to the next one. So the next one is a relative frequency. Remember what is a relative frequency? The frequency divided by the total frequency, right? Okay. Or the number of data point. Okay. So in this case, the number of data point will be what? 9 plus 4 is 13. 13 plus 7 is 20. 20 plus 9 is 29. 29 plus 4 is 34. 34 plus 3 is 37. So the total 37, okay. And what they're looking for, yeah. Based on the consideration above, find the relative frequency for the class with lower class limit 23, okay. So class with lower class limit 23 will be this class, okay. And the frequency is 7. So you need to do is 7 divided by 37, right? So 7 divided by 37 and then times 100. So the answer is 18.989. Now you need to round up to one decimal place. So your answer will be 18.9, okay, because it's one decimal place, right? Yeah, there is a video there, so you can watch it all, okay? Also, there is a written example here. I think the written example will be give you the textbook. Okay, so the next one is a cumulative frequency. Remember what is cumulative frequency? You can also watch the video here. Okay. It is start with the first frequency and then add all of the frequency that. Before the frequency that you need to find what is the cumulative frequency, right? Okay. So, for example, like what is the cumulative frequency for the second class? So you need to add this two, right? Okay. And if you want to find what is the cumulative frequency for the third class, you need to add this three, or just simply add 16 with 7, okay, and so on. Okay. And you're looking for the cumulative frequency for the class with lower class limit 27 will be this class, and the frequency is 3, so you need to add from here to here, right? Okay, so you have 16 if you add 6 with 10, and then plus 7 you got 23 plus 3 is 26. Okay, so the answer is 26. Okay. Okay, for the next one. Okay. Looking for the class width, it's simply like looking for the what is different between this two consecutive lower class limit or upper class limit. Okay, so you can see different is what from 220 to 240, the different is what 20, right? Okay. You can see from 240 to 260 is the difference also 20, okay, and 260 to 180 the difference also 20. Okay, so the class width will be 20. Okay, so okay, for this one is you're looking for the values in the interval 60 to 65. But not include 65 because it's on the right side is open interval, right? Okay, so it's not include this one. Okay, so you can see you have one here, yeah, and then two. Okay, 3, 4. Yeah, only 4. Okay, so the answer is 4. Okay. Okay, so now the next one is, you know the frequency, and this is the cumulative frequency, but one of the cumulative frequency is missing. Okay. So remember start with the first frequency, right? And then you add these two frequencies, okay? So you got 29. And then to get the next one, you just simply add 29 with this one, with the next frequency. So 29 plus 16, you got 45, right? So the next one will be 45 plus 12. So 45 plus 12 will be 57, right? So the answer will turn here will be 57. Okay, so 19 problem. Okay. So now you have the frequency here, but one of the frequency is missing, right? And you have the cumulative frequency here. Okay. Remember the way to get the frequency, for example, like this one, you add 18 with 17, right? Okay. So in order to get, so as you know this one, so you need to subtract this with this, right? In order to get 17, okay? So the same thing for this one, for looking for the missing frequency here, you need to subtract, what is this guy, right? You need to subtract this guy with this guy, okay? What do you get? Subtract 67 with 54. So something like 13, right? Or if you add 54 with 13, you got this one, right? Okay. So the answer here is 13. Okay. Okay, so the next one. Remember what this is? Bell shape, right? Because it looks like bell, okay? So the answer is bell shape. Okay. It's not uniform because it's not flat, okay? It's not skewed, right? Because it's not, the tail is not coated, right? It's not skewed, right? Because the tail is not coated, right? Okay. Okay, so you got the correct answer. Okay, what is the answer? So to find the class weight, you need to find what is the difference between the lower class limit, right? So in this case, the lower class limit is 1, 3. The difference is 2, right? Difference of from 3 to 5 is 2, from 5 to 7 is 2. So the class weight will be 2. Okay. And to get the sample size, you need to add. You need to find what is the total frequency. So you start with 4, right? 4 plus 5 is 9, 9 plus 9 is 18, 18 plus 2 is 20, 20 plus 8 is 28, 28 plus 3, 31, right? So the sample size is 31. Okay, what is the next one? Based on the histogram above, what is the frequency of the class containing the value 5? Okay, this is the class, right? From 1 to 4, from 4 to 7, 7 to 10, 10 to 13, 13 to 16, this is all of the class. And now you need to find what is the frequency that contain the value 5. So the value 5 will be between 4 and 7, right? And what is the frequency? The frequency is 4, because this number is represent the frequency, and because the frequency is here, so the answer is 4, okay? Okay, so now number 13, sorry. Given a cumulative frequency distribution, choose the best type of graph to represent the data. Okay. Remember what is the best way to represent cumulative frequency distribution using to represent the data. I think to be Hogarth, right? Remember this graph? Okay. Oops, sorry. I keep closing the. Yeah, remember the last time that we discussed? This is called Hogarth, right? Okay. Yes, you can see here. Just the cumulative frequency. Okay. So represent as Hogarth. Okay. So the answer here is Hogarth. Okay, so the next one, 14. Determine the distribution of the data pictures below. So because the tail is go to the right, so the answer is go to the right. Okay. Okay, so the next one will be okay. Looking for what is the sample size of this data? So you need to add all of the frequency, right? So it start with 3. 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 plus 10 is 15. 15 plus 13, 28. 28 plus 11, 29. 29 plus 2, 31. 31 plus 2, 33. Yeah. So the answer is 33. Yeah. Oops. Wrong. Okay. Let me see. I think maybe I made a mistake here. Okay. 3 and 2 is 5. 10, 15. 15 plus 13, 28. Right? 28 plus 11. 28 plus 11 is 39, right? 39 plus 2, 41. 41 plus 2, 43, yeah. So 43, okay. not 43, that's right. Here you go. Yeah, if you have any questions, just stop me, okay? Okay, for this one, what is the maximum possible tree height for the data recorded for this histogram? Yeah, so what is the maximum possible tree height for the data recorded for this histogram? Note its class contains its lower class boundary, but not its upper class boundary. Okay. So all of this number is represent the lower class boundary for all of this class. Okay. So if you're looking for the maximum, because this is represent the lower class boundary, so you need to subtract in order to get the maximum. You need to subtract 95 with 1. Okay, so you got 94. Okay, so the answer is 94. Questions like this. If you're looking for the upper class boundary for this class, you need to subtract this from 1, right? Because this one is represent the lower class boundary for the next class or the second class, okay? So if you continue, so that mean to find what is the upper class boundary for 90, so you need to subtract 95 from, I mean, if you look, well, the maximum number will be the upper class boundary, right? So, because So the you can see the different what is here. So the class weight should be 4, right? So in order to get the maximum number, you need to add 90 weight 4, or you could just simply subtract 95 weight 4 weight 1. Okay, so you got 94. Okay. So this will be the maximum number here. Okay. If the question is minimum number, I mean the minimum height of a tree, so the answer will be 55. Okay. But because this not include the upper class boundary, so if you got 95 here, you need to subtract from 1. Okay. I mean you need to subtract 1 from this. Okay. So you got 94. Okay. Yeah, I know this is a little bit tricky, so here be careful. Okay. Okay, what is it now? What is the frequency of times the limit was exceeded by less than 4 items? Okay. So 4 items will be in this class, right? Okay. And what is the frequency less than this item? So that means you need to add the frequency left of this, on the left of this frequency or this class. Okay, so the answer will be 10 plus 9, 19. 19 plus 7 will be 26. Okay, so the answer is 26. Okay, so the next one, 18. Remember Pareto chart, right? It start with the highest and go to the right with the lowest, right? And you're looking for how would the second bar in the graph be labeled, okay? So the second bar will be the second highest, right? What is the second highest here? I mean the second highest value. Okay, so the first highest I think is 98, right? The color is gray, okay? Comments are light gray, okay? So the second highest will be 42, right? And the color is what? Dark gray. Okay, so you need to answer is dark gray. Okay. Okay, so next one is will be the last one, right? Okay, I think this one is the easiest one. So you can see here, this is represent 10. The tens. Okay, this is represent the tens, and this one represent the ones, right? Represent the ones. Okay, so you can see here you have 40, so you put 4 and 0, right? And you have 45, this one, right? So you put 5 here, and then you have 46, this one, so you put 6 here, and you have 7, I mean you have 47, which is this one, so you put 7 here, and then you have 48, this one, so you put 8 here, right? And then you have another 48 here, so you put 8 here, and then you have what, 49, this one, so put 9 here. And what is the other 49? This one, right? So you need to put 9 here, okay? And so on, if you continue for the 70, so you have 72, right? So you have to put 2 here, okay? And then you have 73, you have to put 3, okay? 72, 73, and 79.9. I think that's all right. Okay. So you have 72, 172, this one. 173, this one. And then you have 79, this one. So put 9 here. Okay. Yeah, make sure you, before you check the answer, this will be in order. Okay. Yeah, I think that's all right. Okay. So, do you have any question?
No questions.
So, is this clear for all of you, right?